the mind of Christ. Come on. It's about time for you to lose your mind. Amen.
Yeah.
Come on now. Let's get out of your mind. Let's get in Christ's mind. Amen. Mind the things of Christ. Amen. I just thank God for God being God. Amen. We be here to thank God for God's people. All we tell everybody is this famous preacher, he's good, boy, he's good. But I tell him I don't like one thing he's preaching. That ain't nobody, ain't that going to heaven but people. So I'm looking for people. Come on. I'm looking for some living soul. Even if you ain't alive, I want to see God bring you back alive.
Amen.
Come on. Come on. You know this thing is real, amen. I'm talking about it like camel soup. Good. Come on now. Anybody have any camel soup? Y'all heard the commercial? Good.
Yeah.
That's what they got for. Well, that's what made Jesus so good. Come on now. Cause I, oh, hallelujah. I tried it. Come on.
Amen.
Anybody tried it?
Yes, sir.
And they know.
I know.
That they know.
That I know.
They know. Come on now. So you got to know that you know now. Come on. You really know.
Yes,
come
sir.
Come on now. Oh, hallelujah, I feel him up here, but I just
pour it on in Jesus.
Can't explain God.
No words.
It's just, no words.
No words.
But all I can say is just obey.
Yes.
Obey the words of God. Obey what God tells you to do. Just obey. Because you can't see the rest of the story. You looking at your little circle. But you remember the children to sing the song? He got the whole world in his hand. He got the whole world in his hand. He got the whole world in his hand. He got the whole world in his hands. Yeah? And you looking at your portion. Come on now. He got the whole world. And you are part of him. Therefore, he can send you anywhere in the world because this is his. Come on now. And anywhere there's a soul that needs to be saved, he got to dispatch somebody that got an ear to hear. He that have an ear to hear what the Spirit is saying, not to the building, not to the building, but to the church.
Yes.
Come on now, you are the church.
Amen.
He said, I'm going to get a church out of a church. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm going to get a church out of a church. Come
yes,
on,
sir.
You may be in a church, but I'm going to get me a church out of that church. Come on, because that's going to be the real church of living God. Come on now.
Amen. Woo.
See, Jesus gone on where he took his body. Jesus took his body to heaven, but he left this body.
Amen.
You are the body of Christ. If he took this body out of this earth, this whole thing would crash. Because we holds it up. He can't destroy it because we are here. Oh my God, anybody get this thing?
Amen.
Come on now, that's why he told me to hit my friend. I. Oh my God, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, Abraham, I can't do this that I let you know. Come on, I can't destroy it till I come by your house and let you know what I'm finna do. Come on now. Huh? And he began to intercede. See, that's why God come to let us go say, so we can intercede for the sinner. Because what? He don't know no better. Why? Because we were one too, wasn't we? I know I was. I'm pretty good. That's why I praise God like I praise him now, because I want to be a pretty good one. Come on now. Huh? I'm fearful. I'm afraid. I'm shaky. Come on. I was sitting up, brother, said, you ready? I'm still shaking, I'm still nervous, but when the hat drops, it's time for me to move, I'm moving. Because it ain't about me. If I look bad, he gonna look bad. Come on. And guess what? He ain't gonna look bad. Come on. So that's why I just go ahead and move. Come on.
Amen.
So if God tells you to just go ahead and move. Come on.
Amen.
Because it's unbelievable what God can do. Because when God spoke to me and told me to go to Hopkinsville, Kentucky, boy, I fought that thing like nobody's business. Went into the bathroom for 3 whole days, fasting and praying, without water, without food, without seeing anybody, in a little bit of 4x4, come on, trying to change God's mind. And after 3 whole days, God said, I said, get on down there to Fort Campbell. Come on now. And that's where they were sending everybody to the war zone. Come on now. God, you put me in the middle of the fire. That's what it looked like. Come on. But I said, God, when God told me to get, I said, God, at your word, I'm going.
Amen.
And God, if it don't work out right, it's your fault.
Amen.
Come on. Have God ever told you to do something? gonna come out right. You tell God, did I do what you tell me to do? Or you just let it go? No, you gotta charge. He wants you to charge it by doing. So that means you're standing on what he said, and you're doing what he said. Now, oh my God, hallelujah, come on. Glory to God. You can preach up a storm, man. But I fought it. I'm just going to shout because I fought it. And since I began to come into some of the place that God brought me into to meet new people that I've never met before, I'm almost ashamed of myself. Trying to fight against God. To come to some people like God and got here loving people that come together, work together, love together, come play together, and just work out them. Oh, like I can't even talk about how good these people is. And everybody in here that I come into contact with been a blessing to me. Been a blessing to me. Without you all, I don't know if I sustain. Come on. Spiritually. Come on. Because there's some people that dying spiritually because they have nobody to pour into them. Come on now. And every now and then you need somebody to pour into you. Because every now and then you sprain a leak. Come on now. Because sometimes we are leaking people. We are leak. We'll sprain a leak and we'll leak out. Because sometimes we get a word, right? Soon we get a word from the church. Soon we walk out the door. Somebody come say something. And then we start leaking. Huh? Or to take one more good hot message. And somebody say one word to you, and you lose it. Amen. There's been fight after messages went off. Come on. That's why sometimes I go to them big old conferences where they really do some crazy stuff. I go by myself. Because I don't want nobody talking no stuff to me. Come on. Amen. If anything needs to be said, God, you tell me. Come on. Because when I get in, I want to keep it in. I don't want to leak. Come on now. Oh, my God. But I just praise God for you. God done. My mother is gone no to help, but I honor her because she prophesied all this in existence. It was too big for her to even say. The ministry is the people that I was coming to contact with. Oh my God, hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. I was just sitting there thinking about how the people that how they doing it. It's working out. I'm a stranger in this land. Was a stranger. I'll put it like that. Well, how can it? It's not possible. Huh? Y'all don't even know where I come from. All y'all know he just showed up. How did he get here? Where did he come from? Who is it? God sent you. You all are God. You are blessed. Highly favored of the Lord. Don't let nobody say, oh my God, I feel a miracle in the house. I feel a miracle in the house. There's going to be a miracle in this house. Throughout this revival, there will be miracles. Amen. Get ready for a miracle. Amen. A miracle is coming to this church service. Oh my God, God is looking on Bowling Green because there's something going to happen in this city. And God is bringing this to seal this thing. And then you such a little, oh my God, hallelujah. I can't use such a little people as this to set this thing up. Because see, if you talk to them boys in the basement, they ain't going to hear. They going to do it the way they want to do it. But see, if God can take the little one, he'll do it like God said. And the enemy going to come in and try to make a struggle, but you going to fight your way through. Come on now. Oh, my God, let's get the word in. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, my God. Hallelujah. Oh, God.
Hallelujah.
Now then I get the power surge. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. I've been known to preach all the last time. Before I preach up the story. Hey, let's go to 1 Peter chapter 5. We won't be long tonight. We'll leave the first night. First Peter chapter 5, verses 6, 7, 8. Amen. Amen. You have the amen. Hold me. Await us, hold us. 6, 7. Humble yourself, therefore, under the mighty hands of God, that he might exalt you in due time, casting all your care upon him, for he careth for you. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour. Whom resisteth steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same affliction are accomplished in your brothers that are in the world. But the God of all grace, who had called us unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after that he have suffered a while, makes you perfect, establish, strengthen, settle you. To him be the glory and a mention unto ever and ever. Amen. And tonight we talking about the adversary. So the adversary is your opponent, your rival, your enemy, your antagonist, your hostile, he's your combatant, he's your challenger, he's your contender, he's your competitor, the opposer. Come on. He come to oppose you, he come to stop you, he come to make you shut up, he come to make you quiet, he come to get you. Woo! John said he come to kill, steal, and destroy. But Jesus said, I came to give life and life abundantly. So I come tonight to tell you in this revival that there is an adversary, amen. And he is the devil, amen. And he's not my friend. He's not my buddy. He don't like me and I don't like him. And I don't take too much, don't take up no time with him. When he comes around me, I begin to plead the blood of Jesus to let him open and loose your Satan in the name of Jesus, amen. So we have an adversary that come against us to stop us from doing what God had called us to do, because God has called us to do a work. But there is an adversary, which is the devil. Come on now. It's not your neighbor, it's not your buddy, it's the adversary, and he can enter in and cause something to happen in that person, but it's really the adversary, because he know what God has called you to do, and he's trying to hinder. Come on now. He can't stop, but he can hinder. And he hinders sometimes by scaring us. That's why I say they come like a roaring lion. Rawr. See, that lion may be the baddest thing in the jungle, but when he make that roar, he scared everything in the jungle. Everything just shake up and can't move because of the noise. Come on now. But Jesus already pulled the teeth, so he can't do nothing but gum you. Come on, he can't even get a good bite. Come on now. Because he told us to put him under our feet, amen. Feed the blood of Jesus. He gave us power from on high to get on that head, and we'll just speak the words of God. We can put him in his place, but he always going to try to rise up. That's why you're going to have to be prayed up and stayed up. Can somebody shout glory? Glory! Hallelujah! Glory now! Woo! See, he don't like you to make no noise, because that more noise that he made, he wants you to shut up so he can innovate you. Woo, my God, hallelujah. Come on. Your adversary. The woman, she went to the unjust judge. She told him, "Avenge me of my adversary." Come on. Huh? But the unjust judge said, "I don't fear God, nor do I fear man. I ain't got to do nothing." But she kept on coming. Come on now. See, when you don't get your prayer answer, you got to keep on coming. Come on now. Huh? Whatever it takes to get your prayer answer, that's what you do. Come on. I don't know if y'all know anything about praying and fasting. Come on. Pushing away your plate. You want to call a man to God and let him fast for you, but you won't do no fasting. Ain't nobody home at your house. Knock, knock, knock. Come on, you want somebody to do all the work, and you just say, "Pray for me, pray for me, pray for yourself sometimes." Come on now. You got the power. You know God. Come on. You've been to church long enough not to lay hands on your own self. Come on. Huh? But he going to come and charge it to you sometime and try to, ooh, my God, hallelujah. Because I always tell everybody, just pray for you, get you some oil and slap your own self.
until the call to preach. I've been preaching that and preaching that and preaching that everywhere I go. Come on now. I got a call to come preach in Detroit, man. I'm just felt like getting to go to Detroit. Ooh, good God, somebody. Scared no, no boy. Come on. Think about how big the church was with all them degrees they had. It ain't even on the thermometer. Come on. Scared and shaking, praying and fasting about to get to Detroit, get to the church. It's a little bitty church in the big old city of Detroit. Come on now. Down home, folks. Come on. They got black folk visiting them, different ones coming in visiting them, they come in visiting, coming together. I said, God, nobody but you can do that. Come on. He know what you qualify for. See, when you worry about a whole lot of things, how to, you try to figure it out when he already got it worked out. Come on now. I went down there, boy, and they said they would treat me like a king. Boy, I felt pretty good. Come on. Run Rosario every night, God will move like nobody business. And come on. I was supposed to eat this big old banana split. I was waiting on the third to eat this banana split. And I'd have fasted all day. And by the time I get ready to go to church by 2 o'clock, I get sick. Come on. I can't keep nothing in, can't keep nothing down right at time to go. And so I'm trying to say, God, what am I going to do now? I don't come all this way. And I just, God, you going to let this happen? Come on now, God. God, you the one sent me here. I didn't ask for this, God. You did. So, God, come on now. I know you ain't going to let the devil do this, God. Come on, God. Because me and you, we in this thing together. Come on. And I got to walk through that. I start sitting down, throwing a pity party for you. You know how we do. Anybody here?
Amen.
Get up off your do nothing and do something. We got a God that got all power. If we'll just call on that name, that power in that name. If we'll get up off our do nothing and do something and begin to talk to God, because he know all things. He is in control. I got up. I begin to walk the floor. I begin to preach to my own self. Every now and then you might have to preach to yourself. Don't wait for nobody to preach to you. Preach the word to your own self. I begin to preach to myself. Then I thought about what I told everybody. Get you some oil and slap your own self. Come on. I grabbed me some oil. I slapped myself. I said, in the name of Jesus, I got dressed and I went to church. Woo! Come on. God came in there to move in the mouth. I had never had another problem. But if I'd have gave in, come on now. We give in, don't give in. If I'd have gave in, I'd have messed up. And the same night that I preached there was another preacher there that asked me to come preach in Bowling Green. Bowling Green, but it, Ohio. Right off the interstate. Come on now. I would have missed it if I had heard God spoke the word.